Hi, good morning. Dear friends, how are you? Are you all ready to learn? I'm very happy to see you. Today we are going to learn present perfect tense. So already in the previous class, we have learned simple present tense and the present continuous tense. So today we are going to learn present perfect tense. Are you ready?
Present perfect tense. The present perfect is a verb tense which is used to show that an action has taken place once or many times before now. The present perfect is most frequently used to talk about experiences or changes that have taken place, but there are other less common uses as well.
Now we are going to see how to form present perfect tense. Have or has plus past participle of the verb. For example, I have done my homework. We have done our homework. You have done your homework. She has done her homework. He has done his homework. They have done their homework.
How to form present perfect tense? Have or has plus past participle of the verb. Present perfect forms. The present perfect is formed using have or has plus past participle. Questions are indicated by inverting the subject and has or have. Negatives are made with not. Statement, you have seen that movie many times. நம்முடைய சாதாரண ஸ்டேட்மெண்ட்ல இப்படி யூ ஹாவ் சீன் தட் மூவி மெனி டைம்ஸ். நெகட்டிவ் வரும்போது அல்ல யூ ஹாவ் நாட் சீன் தட் மூவி மெனி டைம்ஸ். குவஸ்டின் சொல்லும்போது ஹாவ் யூ சீன் த மூவி மெனி டைம்ஸ். லைக் திஸ் வி ஹாவ் டு யூஸ் இட். சோ ஃபர்ஸ்ட் வி மஸ்ட் நோ வாட் இஸ் பாஸ்ட் பார்ட்டிசிபிள் ஆஃப் வெர்ப். டிஃபரெண்ட் ஃபார்ம் ஆஃப் த வெர்ப்ஸ். See here, first we can see the present tense. Go, write, see, these are present tense. For the go, past tense went. Write, past tense wrote. See, past tense saw. Past participle, go ku past participle gone. Write ku written. See ki seen. Present participle, go going. Write writing, see seeing. So we must know what is past participle, that is important. So third form of the verb, we used to say third form of the verb, present tense, past participle. We can see some more examples. See here, present tense learn, past tense learned, past participle learned, present participle learning. The same way, go, went, gone, going. Past participle, gone. Run, past tense, ran. Past participle, again run. Present participle, running. Teach, taught, taught, teaching. Play, played, played, playing. Sing, sang, sung, singing. Come, came, come, coming. So we have to see the third form, past participle. That only we are going to use in the present perfect tense. See the how to form present perfect tense. Present perfect tense for the statement, subject plus have or has plus past participle. I have tried sushi. Negative sentence, I have not tried sushi. That means subject, have or has not plus past participle. Question, have or has plus subject plus past participle. Have you tried sushi? So we must know these three kinds of sentences. Now, already in the we know the first person, second person, third person. First person singular I, plural we. Second person singular you, plural you. Third person singular he, she, it, plural they. This already we know it. How to form present perfect tense? I have plus past participle. When it come we have plus past participle. You have plus past participle. He has plus past participle. She has plus past participle. It has plus past participle. Janu has plus past participle. They have plus past participles. See here, for I, we, you, they, for this we use have plus past participle. Only in the third person singular, he, she, it, there we use has plus past participle. So what I said, that only I, you, they, we. So here we get the helping verb have. The main verb, we know the past participle. I have decided, you have decided, they have decided, we have decided, we have lost, like this. Third person singular, she, he, it. So here has gone, she has gone, he has gone, it has gone, like this we have to use it.
We use the present perfect to talk about first one experience, second change, third one continuing situation, fourth one uncompleted action you are expecting, fifth one multiple action at different times. Shall we see this with examples?
Now, where to use the present perfect tense? Till now we have studied how to use the present perfect tense. Now we are going to see where to use. We use the present perfect to talk about our experience, the changes, continuing situation, an uncompleted action you are expecting, multiple actions at different times. Present perfect for experience. We often use the present perfect to talk about our experience from the past. That is the first rule for us. Experience. I have seen Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. He has lived in London. Have you been there? Here? So these are our past experience that we remember now. I have seen Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. They have gone to space. It's an experience, but we remember this experience. That's why we say they have gone to space. Now, we use the present perfect to talk about experience. That means the event was in the past, but connection with the present. In my head, now I have a memory of the event. So, I know something about the event. I have experience of it. That is, இதுக்கு பாஸ்ட் டென்ஸ்ல இது அதாவது இறந்த காலத்துல இது நடந்திருக்கு ஆனா இப்பவுமே எனக்கு அது ஞாபகமா இருக்குது அதான் என்னுடைய அனுபவம் எக்ஸ்பீரியன்ஸ் அதை நான் வந்து பிரசன்ட் பெர்ஃபெக்ட்ல சொல்லணும் வி யூஸ் த பிரசன்ட் பெர்ஃபெக்ட் டு டாக் அபவுட் எக்ஸ்பீரியன்ஸ் நவ் த செகண்ட் ரூல் பிரசன்ட் பெர்ஃபெக்ட் ஃபார் சேஞ்ச் Present perfect for change. We also use the present perfect to talk about a change or new information. Example, I have bought a car. That means, last week I didn't have a car. That is past. But now, I have a car. Now, it's a present. போன வாரம் என்கிட்ட கார் இல்லை ஆனால் இப்போ வாங்கியிருக்கேன்னா I have bought a car. I have bought a car. Last week, they have no car, but they have bought a car now. They can say, I have bought a car. Police have arrested the killer. Yesterday, the killer was free. Yesterday, they didn't arrest the killer, but now he is in prison. So we can say, That is change. Police have arrested the killer. John has broken his leg. Yesterday John had a good leg. Past. Now he has a bad leg. That is present. So we can say John has broken his leg. Present perfect for change. Connection with the past. The past is the opposite of the present. அதாவது இப்போ ப்ரெசென்ட்ல வந்து அது எப்படி இருக்கோ அதுக்கு ஆப்போசிட்டா பாஸ்ட்ல இருந்திருக்கும் இப்ப நேற்றைக்கு கால் நல்லா இருந்துச்சு இன்னைக்கு கால் உடஞ்சிச்சு சோ தட் இஸ் த ஆப்போசிட் கனெக்ஷன் வித் த ப்ரெசன்ட் த ப்ரெசன்ட் இஸ் த ஆப்போசிட் ஆஃப் த பாஸ்ட் ப்ரெசன்ட் பெர்ஃபெக்ட் ஃபார் கண்டினியூயிங் சிச்சுவேஷன் திஸ் இஸ் த தேர்ட் ரூல் ப்ரெசன்ட் பெர்ஃபெக்ட் ஃபார் கண்டினியூயிங் சிச்சுவேஷன் தொடர்ந்து நடக்கக்கூடிய ஒரு இது We often use the present perfect to talk about a continuing situation. This is a state that started in the past and continues in the present. For example, I have worked here since June. அதாவது நான் ஜூன்ல இருந்தே இங்க ஒர்க் பண்றேன் இப்பவும் ஒர்க் பண்றேன் ஜூன்ல இருந்தே ஒர்க் பண்ணிட்டு இருக்கேன் ஹி ஹாஸ் பீன் இல் ஃபார் டூ டேஸ் அவன் ரெண்டு நாளும் அவன் சுகம் இல்லாம இருக்கிறான் ஹவு லாங் ஹாவ் யூ நோன் ஸ்வீட்டி உனக்கு எத்தனை வருஷமா அல்லது எத்தனை நாளா ஸ்வீட்டிய தெரியும் சோ ஹியர் வி யூஸ் த பிரசன்ட் பெர்ஃபெக்ட் The situation started in the past, it continues up to now. நேற்றைக்கே தொடங்கி அல்லது முன்னாடியே தொடங்கி இப்பவும் அது நடந்துட்டு இருக்கு. Connection with the past, the situation started in the past but connection with the present. The situation continues in the present. That is the third rule you have seen. In the fourth rule, an uncompleted action you are expecting. We often use the present perfect to say that an action which we expected has not happened. Using the present perfect suggests that we are still waiting for the action to happen. For example, James has not finished his homework yet. James has not finished his homework yet. அதாவது homework அவன் இன்னும் முடிக்கல நேரத்தை தொடங்கியாச்சு நாம இன்னும் முடிக்கல So, uncompleted action. Bill has still not arrived. The rain hasn't stopped. மழை நேற்றைக்கே தொடங்கின மழை இன்னும் நிக்கல. So here, this is uncompleted action. We are expecting. The rain hasn't stopped. Now, multiple actions at different times. We also use the present perfect to talk about several different actions which have occurred in the past at different times. ஒரே நேரத்தில் நடக்கக்கூடிய actions. Present perfect suggests the process is not complete and more actions are possible. The army has attacked that city 5 times. அஞ்சு தடவை அந்த சிட்டியை அவங்க அட்டாக் பண்றது இப்ப நிறைய செவரல் டைம்ஸ் இட் ஹேப்பன்ஸ் தேர் வி யூஸ் த present perfect. So multiple actions at different times, so many times. So here we can use present perfect. She has talked to several specialists about her problem, but nobody knows why she is sick. அது நிறைய பேர்கிட்ட அவ கன்சல்ட் பண்றா. So so many times, there also we use the present, multiple actions. So there we use present perfect. Look at these examples using for and since with the present perfect. I have been here for 20 minutes. I have been here since 9 o'clock. So we must know the difference between the for and since. I have been here for 20 minutes. நான் 20 நிமிஷமா இங்க காத்திருக்கிறேன். I have been here since 9 o'clock. 9 மணியில இருந்து நான் இங்க இருக்கிறேன். சோ ரெண்டுக்குள்ள வித்தியாசம் நமக்கு தெரியணும். John has been called for 6 months. John has been called since February. அதாவது 6 மாசமா அவன் வந்து has been called. அவன் கால் பண்ணல, பிப்ரவரியில இருந்தே கால் பண்ணல அப்படிங்கறத சென்ஸ்லயும், 6 மாசமா கால் பண்ணல அப்படிங்கறத ஃபார்லயும் சொல்றோம். பட் இன் எவ்ரிவேர் வி யூஸ் த ப்ரெசன்ட் பெர்ஃபெக்ட் டென்ஸ்.
Now we can see present perfect tense to use in negative sentence. How to use? I have not eaten breakfast today. You have not eaten breakfast today. We have not eaten breakfast today. She has not eaten breakfast today. He has not eaten breakfast today. They have not eaten breakfast today.
So negative is really simple too. Just put not after have or has. That's all. I have not eaten breakfast today. I have eaten breakfast today. We used to say the statement. But here the negative we used to put in between not. I have not eaten breakfast today. He has not seen the new film. She has not played tennis. We have not slept all night. Negative short form also we can say I haven't eaten. She hasn't seen. She hasn't played. We haven't slept. Now the questions. To make a questions, put have or has in front of the subject for the yes or no questions. Have you visited London? Yes, I have visited London. Has he worked as a waiter before? Yes, he has worked as a waiter before. Has she met John? No, she hasn't met John. Have we arrived too early? Have they studied English grammar before? So like this. For the yes or no questions, we use the have or has present perfect tense. Now present perfect tense WH questions. Where have I left my umbrella? What have you done today? Why has he gone already? What have you done? Where have they learned English before? Like this, we can use the present perfect tense in the WH questions also.
Dear friends, have you understood the present perfect tense? Thank you. Meet you in the next class. If you like this video, please press subscribe button.